Now I think the picture is going to take us back to the Carroll Street station, where the baggage section would leave early in the morning, a few minutes ahead of the passenger section, to allow for the loading of mail and express at New Westminster. And then the passenger section, which is shown leaving now, would meet that section at New Westminster, where they would couple up and then run together as a single train through to Chilliwack. Well, Frank, you're the interurban motorman, so I think you should take over now and tell us where we're going.
Well, thank you, Vic. It's very interesting. No, you were at those last ceremonies. There's one of the cool ones coming out with the round windows. We always said they look like an owl coming at you. They were a nice, comfortable car, though. Here's the baggage express car that's half an hour ahead of the passenger coach coming down Commercial Drive about 6th Avenue, just about to cross over the bridge at the Great Northern Cut, or which is the Burlington Northern now. There's the bridge with one of the Grandview streetcars crossing the Great Northern Bridge. Here comes the passenger section of the Chilliwack. He just highballs right through. He doesn't make any stops till he gets to New Westminster, and then he couples up with the baggage car. For many, many years, they run two- and three-car trains, sometimes four, but laterally, the passenger travel was cut down, and they were only traveling with the express car and the one coach like they are on this scene. That's the Gladstone Trestle. Coming into Nanaimo Road Station here, and that's Nanaimo Station on the SkyTrain now. That's the passenger section of the Chilliwack. Yeah, here's the baggage car coming down on the Columbia Street, going to head into Track 3 at New Westminster Depot. That building now is the Value Village. If you go in that building, you can still see the posts going through on the angle which divided the three tracks. Here comes the passenger section. Here's a scene that you don't see too often. This is Friday morning market special coming in from Mount Lehman. He's pulling into track two. That'll be the Central Park on track one, the market special on track two, and the number two on the Chilliwack ready to leave. He's been loading the mail and baggage express. Just about ready to go. Now there's the parking ramp is right behind that depot now, but this is many years ago. Here he goes. We're on our way to Chilliwack. Comes out and runs down Front Street. Now we got all them tracks. He's on the BC Electric track is the first one, then the CPR, then the CNR, and then the Great Northern tracks. All in the side by side there. Now he's heading up the ramp towards the bridge. Quite a steep little incline. Yeah, we're right up on the Fraser River Bridge. Now, this is shared by the Canadian National Railroad, the Great Northern Railroad, which is now Burlington Northern, and also the used to be the BC Electric, changed to BC Hydro, and now it's called Fraser Valley and Southern, if I'm not mistaken. Is that hit you right there, Vic?
Yeah, the locomotives have Southern British Columbia on them, but I'm not sure what the full name of the new railroad is. It was acquired from BC Hydro.
Yeah, the BC Hydro did sell it to some, it is a U.S. outfit that owns it now. There's the baggage car coming on the south end of the Fraser River Bridge. You'll notice the trestle goes into three. BC Electric went straight ahead, the Great Northern went to the right, and the other one to the left, the CN. Now he's coming off the ramp, heading towards Liverpool Road Station, where we saw Vic and his wife getting on. That's the station just in the distance there. That was also known as Shops, because it apparently, when they first put the Chilliwack line in, they were going to put huge railroad shops there, but they never did materialize. Here we're coming around the bend to Old Yale Road, which is South Westminster Station. This is where the freight starts to grind when he's pulling a heavy train up here. That's quite a pull. It's about 3% grade up here. Now we're just, we've gone past a Jorth Road station. We're heading towards Scott Road station. He crosses Scott Road twice within a mile or so here. This is the first crossing of Scott Road, and then he just dips into the municipality of Delta, North Delta, out of Surrey, just for a very short distance. As he goes around the bend, he's climbing up there, and he goes past 96th Avenue, crosses Scott Road for the second time, and comes to Kennedy Station. There's a big siding at Kennedy Station where the freight, if you had too many tons, you had to take the first cut up and put it in the siding and run back and get the tail end of the train and bring it up. Kennedy Siding was at the top of the hill. It's very populated there now.
Frank, I note the viewers may notice that the trolley pole arrangement on the trains, this train is different to what was on the Central Park line. You notice that the front trolley pole on the baggage car was pulled down and the pole on the rear car was up. I gathered there was a reason for that in case the pole broke on the front car or the back car, at least it would fall onto the right-of-way. Do you remember that as being the reason for that pole configuration?
Yeah, apparently that if the pole did come loose, it would go right down the aisle of the coach, so they always went with the back car. Well, we're traveling right along here. We're down at Sullivan Station now. We've crossed the King George Highway, and this is Sullivan he's coming into. The film eliminates several Hunt Road, Craig's, and Newton stations. Now we're coming across, this is the Serpentine River, and this is where it crosses Highway 10 at McClellan Station. Now he's coming towards Cloverdale. That is the old Highway 99, Cloverdale Station. You'll get a glimpse of the old Seoul substation here, which has just recently been torn down or knocked down. It was all solid concrete. There's the station, the depot. That's the grain elevator, and in the distance is the substation, that square roofed building. That with the ivy all over, did I don't know if there was just a short glimpse. Now we're on our way. We're going to heading for Hall's Prairie, which was a meeting point for the trains, siding, and also a station. He's moving right along here. You can see by the way the cameraman's bouncing there. That's Hallsbury Station. Just around the bend is the siding, Hallsbury Siding. Now their brakeman's out there getting the switch to taking the hole there. Here comes the baggage cart. All lined up. He's on his way. That was the most common setup. Two coaches on the back with a baggage car on the head end. That was number two left in the morning. Oh, he's leaving Hall's Prairie. He's getting by Hunter and Anderson. This will be Anderson Station. Now, just about Hunter is where the new bypass cuts off. The main line doesn't go through Langley Prairie anymore. Turns off and bypasses Langley about Hunter Station. That's Hunter coming up there. It veers off to the left of the main line now. There's Langley Station. He's coming into Langley. Now this is the blue mail truck there. He's picking the mail up off the baggage car. And the traffic there was the old Yale Road or Trans-Canada Highway at that time. These are just shots around Langley, taken of all the newer buildings and to show what it looked like in those days, which it was a growing town, Langley. There's the Brackman Kerr building. The railroad went right alongside of it. There's some more stores. Pretty modern little town for around the late 40s, early 50s. That's the Trans-Canada Highway. There's the schedule board on the side of the station. Let you know what time the trains are due in both directions. There he goes. He's leaving Langley. Right by the Brackman Kerr, and he's going by Norris. Now, this is where the bypass, the new railroad, cuts back in, and it goes right along the side of Highway 10. This is Milliner Station. It's all pretty well perfectly flat right here, and he could get it rolling real good. Now, these pictures are obviously taken from an automobile going on Highway 10, right parallel to the track. Right now, this part of the track is shared by the CNCP and the Fraser Valley Line for the coal trains. They cut off at Harmsworth Station, which is just a couple of stations up the line here. We come to Jardine first. Jardine is where the road cuts off to go to Fort Langley. There he's around on the bend. There's Jardine Station. And right just about here, it must be where the freeway goes underneath the line. Now he's starting to climb a wee bit here. Not too bad yet that he's coming around to Harmsworth. And at Harmsworth Station is where the coal line cuts off and goes over to the CN. That's Harmsworth there.